the singing of our national anthem as Lieutenant Colonel Chad Gibbons from Rawlins Air Force Base sings our anthem.
What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting, still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
watches the jet bridges show center from the left and the landing configuration chips will select the max afterburner and roll the aircraft 360 degrees while cleaning up the air class. Ladies and gentlemen, from the left, the Super Hornet, Gary Roll.
Super Hornet will now show you
from the left, the carrier.
vapes if we get them. Going down, so we're not getting as much vapes as we did earlier from pressing. At night, night vision goggles and a forward-looking infrared system are used to amplify existing moon or background light and assist the crews with locating and recovering people and vessels in distress. And you see it, the Dolphin, the LH-65D, that's the one that's going to bring the water. Drink.
All right, really?
The Dolphins, the Dolphins, crew speed of 135 knots, servicing at 10,000 feet at 200-mile nautical range, make it an ideal platform for the complex search and rescue, the maritime law enforcement, and marine environmental protection missions that are commonly taken on by your United States Coast Guard. To complete these missions, and
consisting of two AH-1s circling high overhead at the intended insertion point for the recon team's landing zone. One of the Cobras, 3-3, will descend to check out the landing zone, while the other Cobra, 3-4, remains high in the overwatch to help provide any supportive firepower if needed.
Thank you.
Watch out.
States.